Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you
congregations, and they look very skeptical of that dream. You know, I think we're all skeptical about some things. Even in the Bible, I think if we're honest with ourselves, there are some things we are skeptical about. Now, I really don't think that's a bad thing. When Mary had the dream, the first thing she said when she had the dream about bearing a son and naming him Jesus, the very first thing she said was, "How can this be?" She was skeptical. In the time of Jesus, people were very skeptical of Jesus, the scribes and the Pharisees, and probably the people. They heard of his teaching and his preaching, and many things he said they were probably skeptical about. When he did miracles, the people were probably skeptical. Most people are skeptical of some things. Thomas, we all remember Thomas. Jesus had died and he was raised from the dead, and the disciples said, we have seen Jesus. And what did Thomas say? Thomas said, unless I see the marks, unless I put my hands in those marks, I will not believe. That's what Thomas said. Thomas may have been the chief skeptic. Is it okay to be skeptical or to be a skeptic? I think it is, as long as it leads to belief. With Thomas, it led to belief. I was watching the news the other day, and I'm sure not very many people saw this on the news. It was a report out of Gaza, where all the trouble is now. And the report said that 200 Muslims had a dream, the exact same dream. And in that dream, they saw Jesus. And Jesus talked to them. I tried to find out details about the dream, but I couldn't, because so many people were skeptical of that incident. I thought, I wonder what Jesus said to those Muslims. And you know what came to my mind? In that war-torn place where people are suffering unimaginable things, he probably said, "Come unto me, all ye that are weary and heavy laden, and I will give you rest." How many of you heard about that incident? I watch Christian news, and that's how I heard about it. And even on that Christian broadcasting news station, they were very skeptical of that. You know what? I'm not. I'm skeptical about a lot of things, but I'm not about that. No way. I think each and every Sunday as I stand before people, I talk to people that are skeptical, people that have doubt. We all have had doubt and we all have been skeptical. I remember years ago in the Greenbrier District, we used to have preacher meetings. And when we were having those preacher meetings, I complained every day. I hated to go to them. But you know what? Now I miss them. I miss it. And I was thinking back to this one meeting we had at this country church. They had just appointed a new pastor there, and she had been there maybe 3 or 4 months. And she was having a terrible time because a lot of people will not accept a woman pastor, and they didn't want to accept her. If I could remember her name, I would call her name. I remember she preached, and she told the best story. It was such a good story. If I could remember her name, I would call her name just to give her credit for that story, because it is a wonderful story, and it's not mine. But she told the story of being the pastor of that country church. She said she had to open the doors up. She had to turn the lights on. She had to turn the heat on every Sunday and every Wednesday night. She was doing a Bible study, she said. And the people really had not received her or accepted her. And there was one man that was leading all the opposition. And she was having this Bible study, and there were 7 or 8 people there, and she was talking about the Bible study. And it was on the book of Jonah. Jonah. Boy, I tell you, that would be one of the last places I'd do a Bible study, on the book of Jonah. But she's doing a Bible study on the book of Jonah. It was the last night, and she was just about finished. And the chief criticizer of her said, "Wait just 1 minute. Wait just 1 minute." He said, "I want to ask you a question. I want to ask you a question. Do you believe? Do you believe that Jonah was swallowed up and spit out by a big fish?" I remember her saying she didn't know what to say. She had to be honest, She didn't know what to say. And she said this. She said, I am skeptical about that. And she looked at the man, and he just shook his head. And she thought, oh boy, that's it. I've done messed up now. They sang a song, and she shaked hands with all the people. She went and cut the lights off. She cut the heat off. She walked to the back door, pulled her keys out of her pocket, and was locking the door. And she heard a voice say, hey, hey. And she looked, and it was that man. And this is what he said. I am also skeptical about that. Being doubtful, questioning things are okay. They're okay if it leads to the truth. The gospel story is full of things that are hard to believe. And it is. It's okay to be skeptical. It's okay to question things. Keep doing it. But open your hearts and your minds to the Spirit of God. That Spirit that passes all understanding. And it will lead you to the truth. Christmas story is a miracle. It is a miracle. Jesus' life, his death, and his resurrection is a miracle for all of us to receive and to believe, even the skeptics. Amen.
This perfect lamb, that sleeping child, your whole